celebrity beefs. Are we gonna fight while we talk about celebrity beefs?
Yes.
Probably are.
Let's get ready to rumble.
All this is because recently Snoop Dogg said that Eminem and he have squashed their beef.
I felt like I was out of pocket. You know what I'm saying? And I apologized to him and I let him know.
Our national nightmare is over, people. Eminem and Snoop Dogg are brothers.
Mm-hmm.
You're not buying it?
I mean, they have to perform together on the biggest stage in February for the Super Bowl, so.
Okay. Oh, see, I don't think it's just PR. First of all, we have to explain what happened. So Snoop is giving an interview. They're talking about the top 10 rappers.
Like KRS-One, like LL Cool J. Shall I go on?
He didn't include Eminem.
Shade.
He could be labeled as one of the top 10 rappers ever. I don't think so.
Not only did he not include Eminem, but he made it sound like, you know, Dr. Dre kind of made Eminem.
Like he was just a puppet for Dr. Dre.
Dr. Dre helped him find the best Eminem that he could find.
Eminem got in his feelings about it and did a rap verse. Cause that's what you do.
And as far as squashing beef, I'm used to people knocking me, but just not in my camp and diplomatic cause I'm trying to be last thing. I need a Snoop Dogg and me. Man, dog, you was like a damn god to me. Nah, not really.
Hip hop is actually about beefs. That's yes. What rapping battles are about. And Snoop pointed out that they're both battle rappers.
Is that a tank top or a new bra? Look, Snoop Dogg has got a boob job.
And he said recently that they've come together and kumbayaed.
I appreciate that he said he had a growth moment.
Do we think weed was involved in that growth?
We're not doing that.
I'm just saying he might have been a little mellowed out. Celebrity feuds are actually as old as Hollywood itself. Let's take it all the way back to the 1930s. Joan Crawford and Bette Davis.
You don't think I remember that, do you?
It's one of the most famous celebrity feuds ever.
Yeah, where social media wasn't a thought and you just counted on just good old-fashioned trash talking and shade.
You aren't ever gonna sell this house. And you aren't ever gonna leave it.
A lot of historians trace their bad feelings towards each other back to 1933 when Bette Davis was about to have her breakout role in X-Lady.
Yes.
They had a huge promotional campaign planned for the film. And here comes Joan Crawford announcing that she's getting divorced from Douglas Fairbanks Jr.
And there goes the publicity campaign.
So, of course, Bette Davis thought she did it on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
From that point, they just had bad feelings, but it completely worked for what has become an iconic film.
Yes.
Whatever Happened to Baby Jane. Their feud was so famous that Ryan Murphy turned it into a limited series. It's called Feud.
Well, I don't want your help. You've always been overrated.
I guess that explains my 11 Oscar nominations.
The Academy doesn't reward you for your talent, for Christ's sakes, Betty.
Of course, there have been other celebrity beefs.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like Taylor Swift and Nicki Minaj are actually kind of like beef magnets. Nicki Minaj has had beef with Taylor Swift, Cardi B, Lil' Kim, Mariah Carey. Taylor Swift has had beef with Nicki Minaj, Demi Lovato, Kanye West, Kim Kardashian West, just about every man she's ever dated.
Ooh, ouch.
It's a lot.
Yeah. What is it about those two?
My theory is that we like to pit women against each other.
That's true.
But in the case of Nicki and Taylor, they're both kind of outspoken in their own ways.
Mm-hmm.
So Nicki tweeted years ago about not having her Anaconda video
My Anaconda don't
be nominated at the MTV Video
VMAs.
Music Awards.
Yep.
And then Taylor thought she was referencing her and came with a tweet about how she'd always loved and supported Nicki Minaj. And Nicki Minaj came back with, girl, what are you even talking about?
Who are you?
And then Miley Cyrus, who was hosting the award show that year, she made some comments which Nicki Minaj thought were directed at her. And then Nicki gets up and as she is accepting an award, she references Miley Cyrus and does the very hood, so what's good, Miley?
What's good, Miley? Listen. Anybody say what's good to you?
Never
and
good.
And you're nearby?
Never good.
It's never good.
It's never good.
It's never good.
Bitches say and they ain't saying nothing.
I think the beefs don't hurt either celebrity a lot of times. It keeps people talking about them. It enables them to come out with music that people can then say, oh, are you trying to say something about so-and-so?
So any publicity is good publicity?
Absolutely.
Even if it's beef publicity?
Absolutely. Even more so if it's beef publicity, because it gives you something to feed on for years. We cannot talk about long-standing beefs and not talk about Dwayne The Rock Johnson and Vin Diesel. Go! Vin Diesel and The Rock started working together in the Fast and Furious franchise with Fast Five. Mm-hmm. And it just does not sound like it was smooth sailing after that.
Yeah, it sounds like it was a rough ride.
I'll see you soon, Toretto.
Look forward to it. So in 2016, The Rock, he jumps on his social media accounts. He starts talking about someone, let's just say not manning up in a way, not being professional. The Rock took those postings down, but it did not stop people saying, oh, so there clearly is an issue between The Rock and Vin Diesel. Two alpha males going at it.
I got this.
And then what did Vin Diesel have to say?
Fast forward to the beginning of 2021, he gives an interview to Men's Health. And he came in from the perspective of, look, I'm one of the producers of the Fast and Furious franchise. And he reminded us that The Rock started out as a wrestler and kind of made it seem like he had to help him along with his acting. The Rock did not appreciate that. So months later, he gives an interview to Vanity Fair and basically says, I said what I said.
Yeah.
Fuck me badly once, shame on you. Fuck me badly twice, shame on me. Is that the saying? That's my saying.
Sarah Jessica Parker and Kim Cattrall played BFFs in Sex and the City.
Yes.
Do not think they were friends in real life.
I love you too, but I love me more.
Sometimes these beefs, they feel more real and more personal. Like you were saying, is it all for PR?
Yeah.
This one I do not think is for PR.
Oh no, this one feels like they genuinely don't seem to like one another.
What is your problem?
I don't have a problem. You have a problem.
In 2018, Kim Cattrall tragically lost her brother.
Yes.
Sarah Jessica Parker did what many people do.
You when send your condolences.
Send your condolences. Kim Cattrall was like, I do not want your condolences. Kim Cattrall said that Sarah Jessica Parker reaching out to her during this tragic time was really just a reminder to her of how cruel she had been to her in the past and continued to be.
And this was a shock to all of us.
Kim Cattrall is not in the reboot that's coming that's titled And Just Like That. I'm kind of proud of Kim Cattrall because I feel like she's standing up for the fact that that was a moment in her life and her career, and she feels like she's moved on. It's sad for us because we want Samantha back.
Dirty martini, dirty bastard.
Thanks so much for joining us. Don't forget, we drop new episodes every Saturday, so hit that subscribe button. And if you want to subscribe to my newsletter, go to cnn.com/poplife.